Hi everyone, welcome to this new video. Today we are again going to talk about collecting mouse responses and using regions of interest in OpenSesame. But today I will show you how you can do this if you want to run your study online by using the OS Web extension of OpenSesame. So first a little bit about regions of interest. Imagine that you have a task where you ask participants which of the following two pictures contains a bunny. And you ask participants to respond with a mouse, or more precisely, you want them to click on the image that they think contains a bunny. As a researcher, you are most interested in mouse clicks on the target, the picture with the bunny, or on the distractor, the picture with the cat. And you are not interested in clicks somewhere else on the display, like in the empty gray area. In fact, you might even want to ignore those mouse clicks on an empty space because it simply means that your participant was not really engaged in the task. So in fact, you want to force your participant to click on one of the relevant parts of the display. And those relevant parts of the display is what we mean by the term regions of interest. So using regions of interest is quite convenient in the normal version of OpenSesame that you use when you want to run your study locally, so for example in the lab. In that case, you can make use of the graphical user interface that allows you to give names to all the elements in a sketchpad. So for example, you can name the picture with the bunny target and you can name the picture with the cat distractor. Then you can link this sketchpad to a subsequent mouse response item. And this mouse response item will then automatically create a variable called cursor ROI, which has the value target if participants clicked on the target, distractor if participants clicked on the distractor, or no value or an empty value if participants clicked somewhere else on the screen. So you can force OpenSesame to continue showing this sketchpad item just as long as is necessary for participants to click on a region of interest so that cursor ROI has an informative value. In OS Web, if you want to run your study online, things are a little bit more complicated, but still doable. But why is it more complicated? If we look at the documentation page of OS Web under supported functionality, we see that the functions that I just mentioned are actually not supported in OS Web. We cannot name elements in a sketchpad, and also we cannot link a sketchpad to a mouse response item. So in OS Web, to use regions of interest and to force your participants to click on an informative part of the display, we need some workarounds, and those workarounds involve a little bit of coding in the language or one of the languages of the internet, and that is JavaScript. So let's get to the programming part. In OpenSesame, I prepared the following experimental structure. I have an experimental loop, a block loop, and a trial sequence. And in the trial sequence, I added all the events that are necessary for this trial. In the block loop, I defined the target and the distractor. I prepared two trials. The target is always a picture of a bunny, and the distractor is a picture of a cat. And I added these PNG files that the cells are referring to in the file pool. And then I'm going to draw these stimuli on screen in my sketchpad item, where I use the square bracket syntax to show the target at an x position of -250, so at the left of the screen. And then I'm going to show the distractor at an x position of 250, so at the right side of the screen. After showing the display, I'm going to collect a mouse response with the mouse response item. And then at the end of the trial, I'm going to make sure that all the output is logged to my output file. As you may remember from the previous video, this trial sequence is a good start for our experiment, but actually, to implement the behavior that we want, that is, that OpenSesame keeps on repeating a current trial just as long as is necessary until the participant clicked on one of the relevant items and not somewhere else on the screen, we need an additional nested loop sequence structure. So I'm going to append an additional loop item wrapped around an additional sequence item, and I'm going to name them click loop and click sequence. And then I drag target display and the response item into this new sequence. The logger can stay where it is. And if you do not follow the reasoning of this additional loop sequence structure, I advise you to look at the previous YouTube video where we explain this procedure in more detail. For now, let's do a test run to see whether so far everything works online. So I click on the Run in Browser icon. And I see that the stimuli are correctly shown. Target distractor. But I'm still allowed to click in the empty space of the display as well. Then still the experiment continues. So we still need to implement the desired region of interest checks. As I said, in the OS Web extension of Open Sesame, we cannot use the graphical user interface for regions of interest. So instead, in this video, we are going to do manually what the user interface did under the hood for us in the previous video. So we are manually going to determine whether a participant clicked within a region of interest or outside of it. And to be able to do that, we need the following information about the regions of interest. First, we need to know the exact location of our stimuli, so the X and the Y position. And by default, images are centered around the X and the Y coordinate, so we need to know where the center of the image is for the target and for the distractor. And we also need to know the dimensions of the stimuli, so how big are they? What is their width and what is their height? Again, for both the target and the distractor. So starting with the X and the Y coordinates, when looking at the script of the sketchpad, you see that for now I determined the X and the Y values of the images with absolute values. Target is shown at an X position of minus 250, and at the opposite side of the screen at positive 250 I show the distractor. And both of the images are centered around the vertical axis, so the Y coordinate is zero. But for our current purpose, it's more convenient to use the X and the Y coordinates as variables instead of absolute values. And to do that, I'm going to define the coordinates in the block loop. So I'll make additional columns for the X position of the target and the Y position of the target, and the same thing for the distractor. Now, as we just saw, the target is always presented at an X coordinate of minus 250. The Y position is 0, and the distractor is shown at the opposite side of the screen, so 250, and again 0 for the Y coordinate. Now that I defined the coordinates of the stimuli in the block loop, I can use the square bracket notation to refer to them in the sketchpad item. So the X position of the target is no longer an absolute value of minus 250, but instead is referred to as X target. The Y position becomes Y target, and we apply the same reasoning to the distractor. Next, we need information about the dimensions of our stimuli. So for each target and for each distractor, we need to know their width and their height. Meaning that in the block loop, I will make four additional columns for the width and the height of the target and the width and the height of the distractor. In my example, the dimensions of my stimuli are relatively forward because I made sure that all the images have exactly the same size and they are perfect squares, so the width and the height are identical. And when looking at the properties of, for example, my first stimulus, I see that my images are 150 by 150 pixels. So I can fill in all these empty cells in my block loop with the same value that is 150. So now my experimental variables contain all the information that I need to calculate the exact location of my regions of interest on the display. So now that we know the position and the size of our images, We can use this information to calculate the range of coordinates that fall within our region of interest. On the horizontal axis, the starting point of this range of coordinates in the region of interest is calculated as follows. We take the x position of the center of the image and we subtract half of its width. And this gives us the starting position on the horizontal axis. To get the end position on the horizontal axis, we use the opposite calculation. We take the x position and we add half of the width of the image. On the vertical axis, the same reasoning is applied. The starting point of the range of coordinates that fall within the region of interest is calculated by taking the y position of the center of the image and subtracting half of its height. And why subtracting? That is because negative values are up. So the end point of the region of interest on the y-axis is calculated by taking the center and adding half of the height. The next thing that we are going to do is to copy this information to Open Sesame. More precisely, we are going to store this information in an inline JavaScript item. So I'm going to grab an inline JavaScript item from the toolbar and I drop it onto the mouse response so that it will appear right after it, because we can only evaluate a mouse click after it has been given. And then in the run phase, I will start by defining the region of interest of the target stimulus. And I'm going to declare the x and the y positions representing the start and the end of the range of coordinates of the region of interest. When going to the manual and then the JavaScript page on the documentation site, we will see that you can get and set experimental variables using the vars object. And this means that all the experimental variables or the names of the experimental variables have to be preceded by the notation vars dot. And I'm going to define four variables: start x target ROI, start y target ROI, end x target ROI, and end y target ROI. And I'm going to use the same calculations as we saw in the PowerPoint presentation. And these calculations will work because we defined the necessary variables like x target and the width of the target in the block loop. And again, to get these variables, we precede the variable name with the vars dot notation. And after defining this region of interest of the target, I'm going to check whether the current mouse click falls within this range of coordinates or not. So in order to do that, you need to know that the mouse response item will automatically create two variables containing the coordinates of the current mouse click. And these variables are called cursor underscore x and cursor underscore y. So when typing these variable names in the variable inspector, you see that they indeed exist. So we need to compare the coordinates of the mouse click to the region of interest. And the logic is as follows. If the x coordinate of the current click is larger than the starting point of the target ROI and smaller than its endpoint, then it means that you indeed clicked within the horizontal range of the region of interest. And the same reasoning holds for the y position of the mouse click. Now, if both the x and the y coordinate of the mouse click meet my criteria, so they both fall within the range of the region of interest, then I'm going to create a new variable that I call target clicked, and I give this variable the value yes. You clicked within the target. And then I close with curly brackets. Else, if those criteria are not met, so participants clicked outside of the target, then I give this new variable target clicked the value no. And then to check my script, I'm going to write the variable target clicked to the console to see whether it is indeed yes if I click on the target and no if I did not click on the target. And because I'm going to look at what is printed to the console, I'm now going to run my experiment locally. So now I'm not clicking on the target, and indeed the value no is printed to the console. And when I click on the target, indeed yes is printed to the console. So it seems like this piece of JavaScript indeed works. And I'm going to rename this item to evaluate target ROI. Okay, but the target region is not the only region we are interested in. We are also interested in the region where the distractor is shown. To do that, we can use the same JavaScript that we wrote for checking whether participants clicked on the target. The only thing is that we have to replace everything where it says target now with the word distractor. So to do that, I will make an unlinked copy of my current inline JavaScript item and I will paste it right after, like this. And I'll call this inline JavaScript item evaluate distractor ROI. And now it's a bit of a quick and dirty way, but it will do the trick. I will use find replace to replace everywhere where it says target with distractor. So I press Ctrl H, I search for target and I replace it with distractor. And now we see that we have a Java inline script that checks whether participants clicked on the distractor. If they did, we create a variable distractor clicked and set it to yes. If participants did not click on the distractor, then distractor clicked is set to no. The sketchpad, as long as participants do not click on one of the items. If they click elsewhere on the screen, then the display should remain on screen until participants give a click in one of our regions of interest. To do that, I will append a repeat cycle item to the end of my click sequence. And in the repeat of the repeat if box, I will indicate that the current cycle needs to be repeated if both target clicked and distractor clicked are set to no. Right, that means that participants clicked elsewhere in the screen, so then the cycle has to be repeated. Now let's do a check to see whether this reasoning actually works. So I'll do a quick test run. And I'm first going to click at the gray area, so not within a region of interest. Now I'm going to click on the target. And you see that now Open Sesame advances to the next trial. Again, I'm going to click in the gray area, and when I click at the distractor, Open Sesame continues. So our implementation of the region of interest works. So we succeeded in implementing region of interest behavior in Open Sesame, not by using the GUI, but by using Java inline script. And we did that because we want to run our study online with the OS Web extension. Thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned for more. See you later.